What's up, you guys? So anyway, that's what's up, and I have another topic for you guys today. This is not going to be a let's play for this topic. I want to get more of these topics out whenever something big occurs, and you know, let's just go ahead and get into my opinion. This is going to deal more of the Wii U fan base and the Nintendo fan base. So if you are not a Nintendo fanboy or don't really care about Nintendo games, this video most likely will not be for you. But with that being said, let's go ahead and get started. A 3, a 2, a 1, intro, go! And we are back. Shout out to YouTube user Madden Nintendo. His link will be in the description for putting the video up on his channel about this news portion for today. Now, today's news portion is talking about the Wii U and the Frostbite 3 engine. If you guys didn't know, the Wii U was originally not able to run the Frostbite 3 engine. If you don't know what Frostbite 3 engine is, basically it's the engine that was used to run Battlefield 3. If you don't know what an engine is, I can't really go over that right now. But basically, the Frostbite 3 engine was originally not able to run on the Wii U. And so games like Battlefield 4, NCAA, or actually that was the Infinity Engine, my bad. So games like Madden 25 wouldn't be able to run on that. I think Madden 25, that may run on the Ignite Engine, I'm not really sure about that. But anyways, the Wii U was not able to run Frostbite 3 Engine, but now it actually can. But I want to go ahead and pull up two articles discussing how what I think EA is actually doing. Now the first one is a couple months ago, it was May the 18th of 2013, and EA was mainly talking about, one of their spokespersons was an idiot. If I'm correct, his name is Bob Somerville. All of these links will be in the description. The site that I'm about to state right now is, or the articles from Kotaku that I'm about to talk about, the first one, and the second one is going to be from Cinema Blend. So let me just go ahead and quote what Bob Somerville said a couple of months ago. The Wii U is crap, less powerful than the Xbox 360, poor online store, weird tablet, tweeted Bob Somerville. So, I don't know how the heck it's less powerful than the Xbox 360, number one, because it's actually more powerful than the Xbox 360 and the PS3 combined. But, you know, he may just get his information wrong. This is why EA is voted worst company in America 2 years in a row. So anyways, back to what he quoted. He said, Nintendo are walking dead at this. Going on to what else he said, he also said, Nintendo are still operating like it is. And one thing also. Nintendo are still, I thought correct grammar was Nintendo is still, okay, whatever, but as he said, Nintendo are still operating like it's 1990s, he says. Going on, he ends up saying that it should have been out of the hardware business and made Mario and Legend of Zelda franchises on the PS4 or the Xbox One. That would be a terrible idea. Can you imagine Mario on an Xbox or Legend of Zelda on a, oh god. Okay, but anyways, he goes on to say, instead they make this awful console. It's utterly an intentional decision to focus our resources on markets which actually matter. Later on, another EA spokesperson says that they have a strong partnership with Nintendo. They released Mass Effect 3 last year, blah blah blah, and that just because they're not making games does not mean that it will just because they're not making games for the Wii U right now does not mean that they're done with the Wii U. So basically that's what the Sega spokesperson was talking about. He was a publisher, he's a spokesperson at the publisher headquarters, so that's what he was talking about. Now what kind of makes me mad is that, number one, this guy, Bob Somerville, was giving all this false information, number one, and number two, he's just screwing up with the company worse than they already have, because let's admit it, EA Sports is a... We'll let you guys figure that out. Anyways, going on to the second article. The second article is from CinemaBlend.com, and it actually is talking about how the Wii U can run Frostbite 3 engine. Let me tell you what the article actually says. My Nintendo News, which is a website, picked up the story from Dual Shockers, who translated an interview that was conducted on the Japanese website 4Gamer, where EA Games label executive Vice President Patrick Sutherland stated, now hear this, Electronic Arts, better known as EA Sports, released Mass Effect 3 and FIFA 13 for the Wii U. But currently, we're focusing our resources on Xbox One and PS4. So it's a fact that the priority of the Wii U is slightly lower. However, making Frostbite 3 on the Wii U is not impossible. Where there are gamers, we'll be there as well. This is the true meaning of omnidirectional. That was handled very professionally. Now, there is one thing, though, with them saying that. Now they have kind of shot themselves in the foot because they actually have no reason whatsoever not to release Battlefield 4 on the Wii U. Now, I'm going to assume that if they do plan on releasing it, if the Wii U has a bigger fan base, which most likely by the end of this year and midway into next year, the fan base will be exponential because of the launch game. I mean, not launch games, but the titles that are coming out at the end, going from this year into next year, the Wii U will probably have a gigantic fan base. And if that's the case, EA will definitely bring Battlefield 4 to the Wii U. But in my perspective, the only way Battlefield 4 will be successful on the Wii U is if they get it on the Wii U within the first 3 to 4 months of the game's lifespan. That's just my opinion. You're able to differ off. Now, my thing with EA stating this, though, is that wasn't it just a month before this that you actually had said that the Wii U was crap? Yeah, you did. So now you've shot yourself in the foot and you've lost your Nintendo fans. You've lost so many of them. But, you know, this also means that Star Wars Battlefront 3, which is a game that was shown at E3, and all you really saw was just like a little slight cutscene. So Star Wars Battlefront Front 3 will also be able to make it to the Wii U, and they also have no reason not to bring that to the Wii U. Games like Mirror's Edge, if I'm correct, also run on the Frostbite 3 engine. So if Mirror's Edge 2 comes to the PS4, which I'm pretty sure I thought it was an Xbox exclusive, but if it does come to the PS4, they also have no reason to not bring it to the Wii U. So prepare for a bunch of petitions online, EA. This is just me trying to tell you. You know, now you've shot yourself in the foot, and I know that they're probably doing this because they know how the Xbox One has turned out. The Xbox One has been getting terrible publicity. And so I honestly think that they're trying to get back with the Wii U because, you know, they can't go with the PlayStation 4 now that they signed with the Xbox One, and now the Xbox One is the PlayStation 4's competitor. In my opinion, I still think that the Wii U or the Ouya at this point may be the PlayStation 4's biggest competitor. But, you know, that's just my opinion. I still think that EA is trying to get away from Microsoft and they're gradually growing away. We'll just wait to see what happens next. And with Don Mattrick leaving Microsoft, this could perfectly be what they're trying to do. But, you know, that's about it. Leave your opinions in the comment section below. If you are a Nintendo fan, definitely please tell me what you think about this. Now that third-party support may be a lot better in showing that the Wii U is not as underpowered as people actually thought it was. But thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy, please leave a like, comment, as always, and tell me your opinions in the comments. If you dislike, tell me why. And as always, I will see you in the next video. Deuces.